Let's work through question 28 from chapter 9. So the question says, a shareholders group, in lodging a protest, claimed that the mean tenure for a CEO was at least 9 years. A survey of companies reported in the Wall Street Journal found a sample mean tenure of 7.27 years for CEOs with a standard deviation of 6.38 years. So we have three parts to this question. First, we need to formulate hypotheses to challenge the claim made by the shareholders group. Then we need to assume that 85 companies were included in that sample and find what our p-value would be. And then come up with our conclusion if alpha equals 0.01. So the way we're going to work through this is our seven-step process. So the first step is to write down the claim. So the claim is that the mean tenure for a CEO was at least 9 years. Another way we can write that is mu is greater than or equal to 9. Step 2 is the opposite of the claim. The opposite is that the mean tenure for a CEO was less than 9 years. So we write that as mu is less than 9. Step 3 is to figure out which is the null hypothesis and which is the alternative hypothesis. Well, the null hypothesis will always have the equality in it. So our null hypothesis here is mu is greater than or equal to 9, which leaves mu is less than 9 as our alternative hypothesis. Step 4 is our level of significance. What that's looking for is your alpha. So we were told earlier in the problem, our alpha is 0.01. Step 5 is looking for the test statistic. This is when we either calculate a z-score or a t-score. So in order to calculate a z-score, we would need to be able to prove that we can use a z-score. So we have those three proofs. But when we take a look at the information that we're given here, we do not have sigma, so that eliminates two of the proofs. And the only proof that could be used here is n is greater than 100. But in our case, our sample size is only 85. So we are going to have to use a t-score. So the formula for a t-score, we take our x-bar and we subtract mu null. So that's going to be 7.7 as our x-bar minus our mu null, which is 9. We just find that up in our null hypothesis. And we divide all of that by s over the square root of n. And those are given to us over on the left side. So we plug in all of our numbers here. So 7.27 minus 9 over 6.38 divided by the square root of 85 simplifies down into negative 1.73 over 0.692, giving us a t-score of negative 2.50. So that's our test statistic. Step 6 is when we use that t-score, when we use our test statistic to find our p-value. So we're going to want to take a look at our t-score chart. And the first thing we need to do is find our degrees of freedom. Well, we find our degrees of freedom by taking n minus 1. So our n is 85, so our degrees of freedom will be 84. So we are looking at just that row on our t-table right now. And now we are going to be looking for our t-score that we found in that row. So 2.50, that's going to be somewhere between those two amounts, the 2.372 and 2.636. So since we're somewhere between those, we can go up to the very top of our chart and see that the area in the upper tail will be somewhere between 0.005 and 0.01. So the p-value is between 0.005 and 0.01. So sometimes when we use a t-score, we won't be given an exact value for our p-value. It's going to have to be between two amounts, like in this situation. So step 7 is our conclusion. So to make a conclusion here, we need our p-value. So our p-value is between 0.005 and 0.01. We need our alpha. Our alpha is 0.01. And so the rule that we have is that if the p-value is less than or equal to alpha, we reject the null hypothesis. In this case, our p-value is less than or equal to alpha, so our conclusion is that we reject the null hypothesis.